नाथ दसानन कर मैं भ्राता, निचर वंश जनम सुरत्राता, सहज स पाप प्रिय पामस देहा, यथावलोक हितम पर नेहा, श्रवण सुजस सुनियाय प्रभु वंजन भव भीर, त्राहि त्राहि आरति हरन शरण सुखद रघुवीर। माय ब्लिसफुल गॉर्जियस सेल्फ विभीषण जी केम विद हिज मिनिस्टर्स वॉकिंग थ्रू स्काई sky walker is they were, and they came and sent in the message, I take refuge in the lotus feet of Bhagavan Sri Ram. I have come to the cooling and soothing lotus feet of Sri Ram, who is always prepared to bestow all love and shelter. Even the whole world comes in surrender. And Sri Ram looked at Sugriva ji and asked him what he felt, what to do. The answer was, I would not hesitate to arrest him. But Sri Ram's face became very serious. All the warriors were actually Sugriva's warriors, and whatever was going to happen was going to influence the whole army. I would like to invite suggestions on this matter, Sri Ram said, and stared at the face of Jambavan. And Jambavan said, nothing is unknown to your holiness. We would totally surrender to your mission, but he is coming from the enemy's party at a very delicate time, and that's why we have doubts about him, Jambavan said. He should not be believed. He has to be tested. If he proves to be sincere, even you should accept, then you should accept him. Otherwise, reject, Angad ji suggested. Better engage one spy to observe him and then deal with him according to that information. This was Sarabha speaking. Sarabha was a great warrior in Sugriva's army. So better we call him and talk to him and then decide. This was Mayanda speaking. Sri Ram's eyes fell on Hanumanji, who condemned all of the suggestions and gave one of his own. And he says, Bhagavan, no one can equal you in dignity, debate and struggle. Even the Brihaspati, the advisor of the king of the planet Swargalok, would feel diffident in advising you. We are your humble servants and must do whatever you wish. Vibhishan is coming to you as a man after abandoning that most heinous of men, Ravan. He has heard of your supernatural powers and divine qualities and how you have given shelter to the forlorn and homeless to grieve. And Vibhishan's request does not seem to be unreasonable, nor does he seem to be doubt-faced. He might want to become the king of Lanka, but that is not a dangerous desire. So easily we are getting the brother of Ravan is our helper, and this is the first step to our success. My lord, I am in favor of accepting him, but only as you wish, Hanumanji replied this way. Whether he is wicked or gentleman, we accept him, Sri Ram said at last, looking lovingly at Hanumanji. One who approaches me I do not reject even if he is full of mistakes and has committed many offenses. I cannot discourage him even if he is a very wicked man. There is only one qualification which I require, and that is that he should approach only me. My vow is that whosoever comes to my refuge, I will give him shelter. My patronage will give him fearlessness, Sri Ram declared. But my lord, it is true that he has come to us abandoning his brother in time of trouble. So how could we be sure he won't desert us under the same circumstances? Sugriva persisted. What you say is valuable. Sri Ram's amiability was greater than anyone's, for he did not remind Sugriva that when he came to him, it was for protection from his older brother also. Mali was also in the same situation. So Sri Ram continued, if Vibhishan aims at gaining the kingdom, his goal is going to be achieved by our success and not our failure. In Lanka, he was probably condemned and suspected because he tried to help Hanumanji, and Ravan could have sent him as a spy to convey all of our secrets so that he could attack us at any time. Sugriva persisted again. My dear friend, Sri Ram said to Sugriva, full of warmth and revealing the depth of his gorgeous personality, suppose you are right, but he may attack me at any moment. So if you are right, if he attacks me at any moment, even then Vibhishan cannot be abandoned. Even my younger brother Lakshman has quite a number of weapons by which he can destroy not only this world, not only this Lanka, but even this world, but also innumerable other planets of the solar system in a single minute. We have been wandering from forest to forest in great danger, only because we never want to trespass or hurt the moral codes of the Vedic way of life. At no cost could we desire to destroy an innocent person only just because we want to kill Ravan. Actually, killing Ravan or grinding any empire into dust or any planet of the cosmic egg is like a child's play for us. However, the mission of our life is to give a living example of the benevolent Vedic way of life so that the history of humanity may rise to a climax of everlasting peace. So, my friend, my vow is whosoever comes into my protection, whether he is an atheist, a demon, a goblin, an enemy, a drunkard, I shall not abandon him or her. This has been one of the principles of my forefathers, and moreover, Sri Ram likes it so much that not only in this lifetime, but even when I shall depart from the planet Earth, whosoever will take refuge in my name, in my form, in my lifestyle, in my abode, I assure him eternal happiness, materially as well as spiritually. This will be until the end of creation, and Hanumanji will take care of it. My friend, no matter how you speak of others, even if Ravan should come, I will accept him even knowing Rakshasas are great sorcerers, great scientists. I cannot escape the very way of my life like a coward. No, not at all. Fear, selfishness and misconception cannot move me from my path. Sakradeva prapannaya tavasmiti jayachate abhayam sarvabhutebhyo dadame tad vratam mama. Whosoever accepts and surrenders to Sri Ram wholeheartedly, he or she is taken care of in every way, in everything. This is the vow of Sri Ram's life. I make him or her fearless and free in all walks, in all dimensions of life, in all parts of the world. This is the proclamation of Sri Ram. Then Sri Ram said in a commanding tone, "Go and bring Vibhishan. I have assured him freedom. And if his brother Ravan comes, bring him too without asking me." "My Lord, O merciful one, you know very well the secret of Dharma, Hindu Dharma. I was just talking according to the laws of politics. Now I understand that Dharma is the way of life of the greatest powerful ones. Or otherwise, when one becomes supremely powerful on the physical, psychological and astral and causal and transcendental planes of existence, the way of life which he automatically develops is no other than the Dharma itself. By your order, my Lord, let Vibhishan become my friend." Sugriva said with folded palms in deep gratefulness, "My dear friends, welcome, brother. Bhagavan Ram is waiting for you." Sugriva and Hanumanji went to receive Vibhishan, who was still in air, in the space, waiting for permission to see Bhagavan Ram. Vibhishan was overwhelmed with the humility and love when he saw Hanumanji and Sugriv, and he fell down at their feet. Hanumanji raised him in his arms and took him to Sri Ram, and he was stumbling in ecstasy at the thought of meeting Sri Ram. His eyes were showering the inner joy of meeting Sri Ram, and his whole body was thrilled and enlightened in the wisdom of Sri Ram consciousness, my dear friends. Vibhishan saw that Sri Ram was the power and love, compassion and wisdom united into one form of an Olympian princely dignity which was beyond description. Avarnaniya he was, achintya he was, inconceivable he was. He had lotus eyes, long arms, round face, long hair, and radiant complexion, and was carrying a large bow. He was sitting in the middle of the Vanaras on the seashore. "My Lord, this is Vibhishan, the heinous one, the younger brother of Ravan, has come. After hearing about your spotless fame, I fall at your feet. Make me your own, O Lord of all orphans." Vibhishan cried from a distance, falling prostrate on the earth in front of Sri Ram and his ministers too. Sri Ram rushed to him and both arms stretched out and folded him in his warm embrace. At that same embrace which Princess Sita achieved as her greatest asset after renouncing two empires of worldly prosperity and performing extreme vows of chastity. The embrace of Sri Ram gives instantaneous realization. Bad embrace calms all sorrows and sufferings of innumerable lifetimes, my dear friend. I have come to you abandoning everything to become yours, Vishnu said, he announced. Ask for any benediction, Sri Ramaswamy's echoed. When I started out, my heart was not totally desireless, but after seeing you, I can ask for only one thing. Give me more love towards your lotus feet. Vibhishana's voice asked, beseechingly, my dear friends. So be it, but friend, you will have to accept a little tribute for taking the trouble of coming here, Sri Ram said mysteriously. Lakshman is not the ocean the combination of all the holy waters? Sri Ram looked at his younger brother Lakshman. Yes, my brother, yes, Lakshmanji said. I want it, Sri Ram said, and Lakshman immediately brought the crystal clear water of Hindama Sagar in his Kamandalu. And Sri Ram said, Vibhishan upon the nearby slab and performed Abhishek ceremony, the coronation ceremony, of Lanka Empire. And he uttered the slogan, all glories to Vibhishan, the king of Lanka. All thousands of Vanaras shouted loudly and it echoed all around the beach, all around the beach, and the ocean arose in tide waves as if it has received the news to spread in all directions. I have given you the empire of Lanka kingdom. You are the emperor of it for one kalpa, that is 4 billion years, my dear friends. Now I have just to fulfill the formality by killing Ravan. He cannot save himself by escaping to any other planet. I will not spare him even if he takes refuge in Brahma and Shiva. Sri Ram's bold and firm and heroic voice echoed and everybody heard it. Prince Angad suddenly raised a question, what will happen if Ravan asks refuge at your lotus feet, my lord? Now Lanka has become Vibhishana's, and if Ravan comes to his senses and takes refuge in me, submitting Sita ji, the empire of Ayodhya will be provided to him. Sri Ram is confident enough that he can establish a new empire in the forest by the power of his mighty arms. Okay? Sri Ram replied without any pause, looking at the face of Prince Angad. All glories to the Olympian Prince of Ayodhya. Sugriv jumped on the in the air and shouted loudly, all glories to Bhagavan Sri Ram. Vibhishan shouted loudly with his ministers, overflowing with great joy and tears. All the Vanaras army began to dance in ecstasy and celebrate a festivity in the name of Sri Ram's unique generosity, and it continued for the whole day. Now, all of them sitting together, now they are asking questions. How can we cross the ocean to reach Lanka? The next morning, Sri Ram was asking the same question he had asked the day before, and the same ministers surrounded him. He glanced at Vibhishan ji, and Vibhishan ji said, आमच।